Moree, and I have farms joining the town on which we grow cotton and citrus and plus grains and things. So I guess we're a good middle-sized family farming business. When governments take water off you, everyone suffers. You know, I'm very clear about that. Everyone suffers. Like, they're looking at probably the last 30 years, which has probably been a drier cycle. If you look at the 50s, the 60s and the 70s, were a wetter cycle. You know, I think if you look at the 30s and the 40s, were a drier cycle. So I think they're all focusing on making the cutbacks because we're in a drier cycle. You know, we farmers play a long game. The more water that's taken off us, the less business you can do. It costs a lot of money to build more sustainable businesses to get higher value and higher productions. You know, it's a very expensive exercise, and I don't see a lot of support out there on that side. If the authority takes more water off the community, obviously it will affect the community. You know, it annoys me that we've got this process that every 5 years they're going to review and take water off you. I can guarantee they will never be giving water back, and they're working over, you know, a 5 year time frame for thousands of years. You know, we farmers are constantly going to lose. Our communities are constantly going to go backwards until we get, you know, better thinking in how we're going to do this and manage it and not have 5 year plans. Once you get a cut back on the water reforms, they should be bedded down and locked down for 20 years.